Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Performing Arts Center at Ridge High School. It's me, Crutchy. My friends and I are so excited to present this true story of young boys and girls who stood up for their rights at the turn of the century in New York City in 1899. At this time, we ask that you silence all your devices and note your nearest emergency exit. And finally, we hope that telling this story will teach all of us that with faith, a plan, and the help of your best friends, you can change the world. And now, Ridge High School proudly presents Disney's Newsies.
Morning bell ain't rung yet. Get back to sleep.
I want to beat the other fellows to the street. I don't want anyone else should see I ain't been walking so good.
Come on, quit griping. You know how many guys fake a limp for sympathy? That bum leg of yours is a gold mine.
Someone gets the idea that I can't make it out on my own, they'll lock me up in the refuge for good. Just be a pal, Jack. Help me. Down.
Hey, whoa, come on, huh? You wanna bust your other leg too?
No, I wanna go down.
You'll be down soon enough, all right? Just take a second to drink with me in my penthouse. High above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Oh, what, because I like a breath of fresh air? Well, because I like seeing the sky and the stars.
Oh, you're seeing stars, all right.
You know them streets down there, they suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs stomped on by bosses, and when they finally broke him, they just tossed him to the curb, like yesterday's paper. They ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
Yeah, New York's fine for guys who can afford a big, strong door to lock it out. But I tell you, Crutchy, there is a whole out of way out there. So you keep your small life in the big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away to a little town out west that's spanking new. And while I ain't never been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you could see it too. Close your eyes, come with me, where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. What a minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son. Welcome home to Santa Fe. Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire. Except for Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends are more like family, and they's begging you to stay.
So you got folks there?
No, I got no folks nowhere. Yo?
Nah, I don't need folks. I got friends.
Hey, how's about you come with me? Then no one worries about no gimp leg in Santa Fe. You know, you just have a Palomino, you know? You'll ride in style.
Feature me riding in style.
You know, I bet a few months of clean air, you can toss that crutch for good.
Santa Fe, you can bet. We won't let them bastards beat us. We won't beg no one to treat us fair and square. There's a life that's worth the living, and I'm gonna do my share.
Work the land, chase the sun, swim the whole Rio Grande just for fun. Watch me stand, watch me run.
Hey, don't you know that we's a family? Would I let you down? No way.
Just hold on, kid, till that train makes Santa Fe.
Time for dreaming's done. Hey, Specs! Racer, Henry, Albert, Elmer, get a move on, boys. Them tapes don't sell themselves. Come on.
Hey, Albert, Elmer, Specs, you were a jack. Get a move on.
I was having the most beautiful dream. My lips are still tingling.
A pretty girl.
Whole leg of lamb.
Hey, that's my cigar.
You'll spill another.
Hey, look, it's bath time at the zoo.
I thought that I'd surprise my mother.
If you can find her.
Who else you?
Hey, they ain't moving like they used to. I need a new selling spot. Got any ideas?
From Bottle Alley to the harbor, there's easy pickings guaranteed.
Try any banker, Bob Obama. They almost all knows how to read.
It's a crooked game we're playing, one we'll never lose. Long as suckers don't mind paying, just to get bad news.
And in a fine line, carry the banner through it all. A mighty fine line, carry the banner through it all. When that bell rings, we go very witches.
Hey, step back, Romeo. Nothing what concerns you here.
Morning, miss. Might I interest you in the latest news?
The paper isn't out yet.
Oh, well, I would be delighted to bring it to you personally.
I've got a headline for you. Cheeky boy gets nothing for his troubles.
Oh. Hey, back to the bench, slugger. You struck out.
Oh, I'm crushed. Hey, Crutchy, what's your leg say? Gonna rain?
No rain. Partly cloudy. Up clear by evening.
They ought to bottle this guy.
And the limp sells 50 papes a week all by itself.
I don't need the limp to sell papes. I got personality. It takes a smile that spreads like butter. The coin that toys a lady's head.
It takes an orphan with a stutter.
Who's also blind
and mute and dead.
Summer stinks and winter's freezing. When you work outdoors, stop sweating and stop sneezing. In between it pours. And it's a fine line, carrying the banner with the charlatans.
Carrying the banner with
the charlatans. A bunch of chicks tossing out of freebies to the boss.
Tossing out of freebies.
What's the hold up? Waiting makes me antsy. I'd like slivin' chancy.
All under the lazy wanna fight life. Carrying the banner through the.
Thank you. Thanks for the grub, sister.
Elmer, when are we gonna see you? Inside the church?
I don't know, sister. But it's bound to rain sooner or later.
Myrtle,
just give me half
the
coffee.
Concrete.
Oh, I gotta find an angle.
Go with mold. Home
it's 88 degrees.
That's a change.
Say anything I have to, cause I do for a penny. If I take too many weasel, just makes me eat them after.
I do too, so it must be true. What a switch, soon we'll all be rich. Don't know a better way to make a Newsies day. You wanna move on next edition, give us a
politician.
Yeah, yeah, wait, that ain't news no more. Up down to Grand Central Station, down to City Hall. We improve our circulation, walk until we fall.
Not again!
You had 3 weeks of the same story!
Because that snoozer!
Make way, step aside!
Dear me, what is that unpleasant aroma? I feel the sewer may have backed up during the night.
Or could it be?
The Lyndsey brothers!
Hey, Oscar! Word on the street says you and your brother took up money to beat up striking trolley workers.
So? It's honest work.
But cracking the head of defenseless workers?
I take care of the guy who takes care of me.
Hey! Now, ain't your father one of the strikers?
Guess he didn't take care of me.
You want some of that too, you lousy?
Hey! That is not nice, Morris.
Yeah, five to one, Jack. Skunk some.
Yeah.
You know, one unfortunate day, you might find you got a bum game of your own. How'd you like one of us picking on you, huh?
Well, maybe we should find out.
Oh! Wait till I get my hands on you.
Well, you gotta catch me first.
Miss me?
The name's Wiesel.
Oh, well, ain't that what I said? I'll take my usual.
100 papes for the wise guy.
How's it going, Weasel?
At least call me mister.
Yeah, I'll call you sweetheart if you spot me 50 papes.
Drop the cash and move it along.
Ooh. Oh, whatever happened to romance?
50 for the race. Next!
Good morning, Mr. Wiesel.
50 papes for Crutchy. Oh, have a look at this. A new kid.
I'm new too.
Hey, don't worry, kid.
rubs right off.
Yeah. I'll take 20 newspapers, please.
20 for the new kid. Let's see the dime.
I'll pay you when I sell them.
Money, kid. Come on. Cash up front.
But whatever I don't sell, you buy back, right?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Certainly. And every time you lose a tooth, I put a penny under your pillow. This kid's a riot. Come on. Cough up the cash or blow. Come on, move it along. Albert, let me see your money.
You have a very interesting face. Ever thought of getting to the moving pictures?
You think I could?
Sure. Buy a ticket. They'll let anyone in.
I'm sorry, excuse me. I paid for 20, you gave me 19. Hey.
You seen how nice I was to this new kid? And what do I get for my civility? Ungrounded accusations.
I just want what I paid for.
He said beat it.
Hey, hey! The new kid's right, Weasel. You gave him 19. Listen,
I'm sure it's an honest mistake on account of the fact that, you know, Oscar can't count to 20 with his shoes on.
Here, now take a hike.
Hey, give the new kid 50 more papes.
I don't want more papes.
Well, what kind of news you don't want more papes?
I'm no charity case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
This here is the famous Jack Kelly. He once escaped jail on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage. Made all the papes.
Hey, how old are you, kid?
I'm 10. Almost.
Well, if anybody asks, you're 7. Younger sells more papes. And if we're gonna be partners...
Who said we want a partner?
Hey, selling with Jack is the chance of a lifetime. You'll learn from him, you'll learn from the best.
If he's the best, then what's he need with me?
Because you got a little brother and I don't. All right, with that push, we could easily sell like a 1,000 papes a week. Look at that, kid.
Oh, we're gonna make millions.
This is my brother David. I'm Les.
Oh, well, nice to meet you, Davey. My two bits come up the top, we split everything else, 70-30.
50-50. You wouldn't try and pull a fast one on a little kid.
Oh. 60-40, and that is my final offer.
Deal.
That's disgusting.
Oh, that's just business. Newsies hit the streets. The sun is out, the headline stinks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
But we'll be out there carrying the banner man to man. We're always out there soaking every sucker that we can. Here's the headline: Newsies on a mission, kill the competition, sell an exhibition. We'll be out.
Trouble! Our circulation is down for the third quarter in a row.
But, Mr. Pulitzer, every paper circulation has been down since the war ended.
Well, whoever said war is hell wasn't trying to sell newspapers.
We could use an exciting headline.
What have we got today?
The trolley strike.
That's not exciting, it's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or ain't it? No one cares why. And the strike's about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt just put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent? Football, violent? You're right, the man's no socialist.
He's a commie!
It's the Neapolitan, you must try and sit still!
People, you are making Nunzio nervous.
And if Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. You wrote an editorial against him day after day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
Well, how can I influence voters if they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without flashy photos or headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
There's a solution right before your eyes, people. You're just not thinking it through. Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can fatten bottom line.
Mr. Pulitzer, please!
Shaving is tricky. The razor should float. Shave me too close and you might slit my throat. It's the simplest solutions that bolster the bottom line.
But how does that help us sell more papers?
We don't sell papers, silly. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now, we charge the Newsies 50 cents per 100 papers.
Yes.
But if we change their price to 60 cents per 100...
Now you're getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single Newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to earn the same amount as always.
My thought exactly. It's genius.
It's gonna be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'm offering them a real-life lesson in economics. I couldn't offer them a better education if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay even more. When there's dirt on your shoes, boys, for God's sake, relax. Why throw them out? All we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, for they'll see you through.
When you're stuck in the muck, you'll be fine. You'll erase any trace of decline with a trim and a snip
and a shine
and the power of the press. Yes, once again is mine. The price for the Newsies goes up in the morning. Just a few common sense, that's the bottom line.
Paper, right here, brand new paper. Oh. paper, evening paper, right here.
Oh. Oh, sing him to sleep, why don't you? Let me see.
You're the extra, extra, terrified plight from Burning Inferno. You have the story right here.
Thank you, mister.
You just made that up.
Well, I did not. I said he heard the story right here, and he did.
My father taught us not to lie.
And mine taught me not to starve.
Hey! Just sold my last paper!
I got one more.
Hey, sell it or pay for it.
Give it here! Buy a paper from a poor orphan boy? Oh, you dear thing, of course I will buy a paper. Here's a dime. Thank you.
Born to the breed!
This is so much better than school!
Don't even think it. When Pop goes back to work, we go back to school.
Oh, how's about we divvy up the money, find some chow, and find us a safe place to spend the night?
We gotta get home. Our folks will be waiting dinner.
Yeah, folks?
Doesn't everyone?
Our dad tangled with a delivery truck on the job. Messed up his leg bad. So they laid him off. That's how come we had to find work.
That makes sense. Too bad about your dad.
Why don't you come home with us for dinner? Our folks would be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Well, thanks
for the invite, but I just remembered I got plans with a fella, and he's probably waiting on me right now.
Is that the guy you're meeting?
Kelly!
Run for it!
You! Yeah, Kelly! Stop! Kelly! Kelly!
All right, slow down. We lost.
Someone want to tell me why I'm running? I got no one chasing me. Who was that guy?
That was Snyder, the spider, a real sweetie. He runs a jail for underage kids called The Refuge. The more kids he locks up, the more the city pays him. But the problem is, all that money goes right into his own pockets. So do yourselves a favor and stay clear of him and The Refuge.
Hey! You up there, Sue! No kids allowed in the theater.
Hey, not even me, Miss Meta.
Jack Kelly, man of mystery, get yourself down here and give me a hug. Oh, where have you been keeping yourself, kid?
I'm never far from you, Miss Meta. The boys, may I introduce you to Miss Meta Larkin, the greatest star on the Bowery today. She also owns the joint.
Please, the only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure, gents.
A pleasure. What's wrong with you?
Are you blind? She got no clothes on!
That's her costume!
But I can see her legs!
Step out of his way so he can get a better look. Theater isn't only entertaining, it's educational. Got the picture, kid?
Miss Meta, I got a little situation out on the street. You mind if I hide out here for a while?
Where better to escape trouble than a theater? Is that Snyder after you again?
Hey, Jack, did you really escape jail on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
What would the governor be doing at a juvenile jail?
Hey, it so happens that he was running for office and wanted to show that he cared about orphans and such. So, well, he got his mug in the paper. I got my butt in the back seat, and off we rode together.
You really know the governor?
Uh-huh. He don't. But I do. Say, Jack, when you've got time, I want you to paint me some more of these backdrops. This last one you did is a doozy. Folks love it. And things have been going so well, I can actually pay.
Hey, I couldn't take your money, Miss Meta.
You pictured that?
Your friend is a real artist.
Hey, don't get carried away already. It's just a bunch of trees.
You're really good.
Yeah. That boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never knew no one with the aptitude.
Miss Meta, you're on.
Really? How am I doing? Lock the doors and stay all night. You're with Meta now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin!
I'm doing all right for myself, folks. I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, I'm wise. My investments and such have all gone up so much. Seems whatever I touch starts to rise. I've been all kinds of lucky, and yet the thing I want most I can't get. I live in a mansion on Long Island Sound. I pulled up a weed, they found oil in the ground. But you're telling me you don't want me around. Now, honey, that's rich. Some guys give me ermine, chinchilla, and mink. And some give me diamonds as big as a sink. But You wouldn't give me so much as a wink. Now, baby, that's rich. I get brandy from Andy and candy from Scott. Oh, and Frank and Eduardo chipped in for a yacht. I get stares from the fellas and prayers from the Pope. But I ran out my luck getting stuck with this mope. Oh, hey, sweetie, I was just talking about you. Now listen, sport. This life's too short to waste it on you. It may be rough, but soon enough, I'll learn to make do with the mansion, the oil wells, the diamonds, the yacht, with Andy, Eduardo, the pontiff, and Scott, and Frank, and my bank. So spill no tears for me.
I should lock the door? Twice in one day. You think it's fate?
Go away, I'm working.
Oh, a working girl, huh? Doing what?
Reviewing the show for the New York Sun.
Oh, hey, I work for the Wild.
Somewhere out there, someone cares. Go tell them.
The view is better here.
Please go, I'm not in the habit of speaking to strangers.
Well, then you're gonna make a lousy reporter. The name's Jack Kelly.
Is that what it says on your rap sheet?
Oh, a smart girl, huh? Well, I admire smart girls. Yeah, beautiful, smart, independent.
Do you mind?
Hey! You got in for free! At least pay attention!
I'm sorry, Miss Meta. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight for suckers, at least it used to be. Look, girls are nice once or twice till I find someone new. But I never planned on someone like you. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight for suckers, at least it used to be. Hey, quiet down. There is a show going on.
You are the most impossible boy.
No, I never planned on someone like you.
fire sirens kept me awake all night.
Fire sirens is like lullabies to me. The louder they wail, the better the headline, and the better the headline, the better I eat, and the better I eat.
The further away from you, I sleep.
Oh, morning, everybody. I'm sorry we're late. We had to help our mom with something.
Ooh. Oh, they got a mother. I was gonna get me one.
What'd you do with the one you had?
He traded us for a box of cigars.
Hey. They was Coronas.
We have a father, too.
A mother and a father.
Oh, and we the hoi polloi.
So how's it going today?
Ask us after they put up the headline.
Here it comes now.
New newsy price. 60 cents a hundred.
What?
Is that news?
It is to me. They jacked up the price of papes. 10 cents more, 100.
I could eat 2 whole days on a dime.
Oh, I'll be sleeping on the street.
You already sleep on the street.
Well, in a worse neighborhood.
Hey, what are you all standing around for?
Get a load of this, Jack.
Like Pulitzer, don't make enough already.
Papes for the nosies!
Hey, relax, all right? It's gotta be a gag.
Line up.
Hey, you know, good joke, Weasel. You really had the fellas going. I'll take 100. Be on my way.
100 will cost you 60.
I ain't paying those 60.
Then make way for someone who will.
All right, well, you bet. Me and the fellas will take a hike over to the journal.
Yeah!
I'll save you the walk. They up their price too.
Well, then we'll take our business to the sun.
Yeah!
It's the same all around town. New day, new price.
Hey, why the jack-up?
With them kind of answers, you gotta ask a little further up the food chain. So, you're buying or moving on?
All right, come here, fellas.
They can't just do that, can they?
Why not? It's their paper.
It's their world.
Ain't we got no rights?
We got the right to starve. Come on, let's get our papes and hit the streets while we still can.
At them prices?
We got a choice.
Hey, nobody is paying no new nothing.
What? And you got an idea?
I don't know. Just keep your shirt on, all right? Let me think this through.
What's your angle?
Jack, what are you doing?
Let the man work it out! Hey, Jack? You still thinking?
Sure he is! Can't you smell smoke?
All right, come here, look. All right, here's the deal. If we don't sell papes, then nobody sells papes, all right? Nobody gets to that window until they put the price back where it belongs.
What, you mean like a strike?
You heard Davey, we're on strike.
We shut down
this place just like them workers shut down the trolleys.
And the cops will bust our heads. Half them strikers is laid down with broke bones.
But the cops ain't gonna care about a bunch of kids. Right, Davey?
Leave me out of this. I'm just trying to feed my family.
And what, the rest of us is here on playtime? Look, just because we only make pennies, don't give them the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
Well, what if I says we is?
There's a lot you gotta have in order to be a union. Like membership.
And, what do you call these guys?
And officers?
I nominate Jack president.
Gee, I'm touched.
How about a statement of purpose?
Oh, I must have left that in my other pants.
What's a statement of purpose?
A reason for forming the union.
Well, what reason do the trolley workers have?
I don't know. Wages, work hours, safety on the job.
Well, who don't need that? Look, I bet if your father had a union, you wouldn't need to be out here selling papes right now, yeah?
Yeah.
So our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Union we stand. Hey, that's not bad. Somebody write that down.
Oh, I got a pencil.
We'll meet our Secretary of State.
Yeah.
So now what?
If You want a strike? The membership's got to vote.
Okay, so let's vote. What do you say, fellas? The choice is yours. Do we roll over and let Pulitzer pick our pockets, or do we strike?
Strike!
Yeah. You heard the voice of the membership. The Newsies of Lower Manhattan are officially on strike. So what's next?
Wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
It would be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself!
Yeah. And who tells Pulitzer? Huh? Davey?
I don't know. I guess you do, Mr. President.
Hey, we do. All right? So what do we tell them?
Well, the newspaper owners need to respect your rights as employees.
Yeah, that's right. Pulitzer and Hearst gotta respect the rights of the working kids of this city.
They can't just change the rules when they feel like it.
Yeah, that's right. We do the work, so we get a say.
We got a union.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think we're nothing. Are we nothing?
No!
They need to understand we're not enslaved to them. We're free agents.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
We're a union now. The Newsboys Union, and we mean business!
Yeah! Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so. And the world will know!
What's to stop some other kids coming along to sell our papes?
Just let them try!
Yeah!
No, we can't beat up on other kids. We're all in this together.
What's it gonna take to stop the wagons? Are we ready?
Yeah!
And what's it gonna take to stop the scampers? Can we do it?
Yeah!
Wonder what we gotta do until we break the will of mighty Bill and Joe. And the world will know, and the child too. Mr. Hearst and Pulitzer, have we got news for you? See, the world don't know, but they're gonna pay. A set of hawking headlines we'll be making on today. And our ranks will grow,
and we'll kick their ass.
Yeah! And the world will know that we've been here.
When the circulation bell starts ringing, will we hear it?
No!
And what if the Delanceys come out swinging? Will we hear it?
No! When you got 100 voices singing, who can hear a lousy whistle blow? And the world will know that this ain't no game, that we got a ton of rotten fruit and perfect aim. So they gave their word, but ain't worth beans. Now they're gonna see what stop the presses really means. And the old will weep and go back to sleep. And we've got no choice but to see it through.
And we found our voice!
And I lost my show!
And the world will. Yeah!
Pulitzer may own the world, but he don't own
us. Pulitzer may own the world, but he don't own us.
Pulitzer may crack the whip, but he won't whip us.
Pulitzer may crack the whip, but he won't whip us. And the world will know. We've been keeping score. Either they gives us all rights or we gives them a war. We've been down too long, and we paid our dues.
And the things we do today will be tomorrow's news.
And the die is cast, and the torch is passed,
and the war will rise
from the streets below,
and grow,
and grow, and so the world will feel the fire and find me. No!
Pulitzer may own the world, but he don't own us.
Pulitzer may crack the whip, but he won't whip us.
Pulitzer may crack the whip, but he won't whip us.
A glass of water for you, and a glass for you, and another one over here for you, and... Oh, who's the big spender who ordered the seltzer?
Over here.
That'll be 2 cents.
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me a water instead.
Hey, how'd I see that one coming?
I'd say we launched our strike in a most auspicious manner.
I don't know about that, but we sure scared the bejeebas out of Weasel.
Did you see the Delanceys? They didn't know which way was up. So what's next?
Well, now you have to spread the word. Let the rest of the city's newsies know about the strike.
All right, you heard the man. Split up and spread the word.
I'll take Harlem.
I got Midtown.
I got the Bronx.
And I got the Bowery.
All right, Specs, you take Queens. Tommy Boy, you take the East Side. And who wants Brooklyn? Oh, come on. Brooklyn. Spot Collins turf. Finch. You telling me you're scared of Brooklyn?
I ain't scared of no toif. But that Spot Conlin gets me a little jittery.
Fine. Davey and I'll take Brooklyn.
Me? I have to? Yes.
Why is everyone so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you doing here?
Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
Brooklyn is the sixth largest city in the entire world. You got Brooklyn. And you hit the muddle load. You know, for someone who works for the New York Sun, you spend an awful lot of time hanging around at the Wild. So what's that about, huh? Are you following me? Oh!
The only thing I'm following is a story. Mm-hmm. A ragtag gang of ragamuffins wants to take on the kingmakers of New York. Think you have a chance?
Well, shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Question too difficult. I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in New York give the time of day who haven't got the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a penny to their name?
Whoa, whoa. Hey, you don't gotta be insulting. I have a nickel.
So I guess you'd say you're a couple of Davids looking to take on Goliath.
We never said that.
You didn't have to. I did.
You know, I seen a lot of papes in my time, but I ain't never noted no Goyo reporters writing hard news.
Wake up to the new century. The game's changing. How about an exclusive interview? But
ain't you beat entertainment?
This is entertaining. So far.
What's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
Oh! You're out of your league, Kelly. Me think. The lady should be handled by a real man.
You think's wrong, Romeo.
How'd you know my name?
Get out of here.
I'd say we save any exclusive for a real reporter.
Come on, guys, we're busy. We got places.
You see somebody else giving you the time of day? All right! So, I'm just busting out of the social pages, but you give me the exclusive, let me run with the story, and I promise I'll get you the space.
You really think that we could be in the papes?
Shut down a paper like The World, and you're going to make the front page.
Front page? Oh, the newspaper!
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right. Look, you want a story? Be in front of the circulation gate tomorrow morning, and you'll get one. And bring a camera. You want to snap a picture of this?
All right. Let's go, boys. Go play outside. I got a setup for dinner. Pay in. Customers need the tables.
Come on. We got newsies to visit.
And you won't be showing us off when we get our mugs in the paint.
And the world will know. We've been keeping score. Be the day is us, all right, so we is. And so the world will
folks are waiting.
So what's your story? Are you selling newspapers to work your way through art school?
Art school? Are you kidding me?
But you're an artist. You've got real talent. You should be inside the paper illustrating, not outside hawking it.
Well, maybe that's not what I want.
So tell me what you want.
Well, can't you see it in my eyes?
Have you always been their leader?
Well, me? No. I'm a blowhard. The Davy? He's the brains.
Modesty is not a quality I would have pinned on you.
You got a name?
Catherine Plummer.
Well, what's the matter? Ain't you sure?
It's my byline, the name I publish under. Tell me about tomorrow. What are you hoping for?
Well, I'd rather tell you what I'm hoping for tonight.
Mr. Kelly.
Today we stopped our Newsies from carrying out papes, but the wagon's still delivered to the rest of the city, so tomorrow we'll stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? Ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Hey, what are you running off to? It ain't even supper time yet.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, Plummer. Write it good. We both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. And if I could just write about it. Come on, Catherine, the boys are counting on you. Oh, you poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady. Don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy sourpusses. Oh, it's a cinch. It could practically write itself, and let's pray it does. Because I may have mentioned I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl? That's a girl. How the hell? Is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's the story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guy some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page, and once they're center stage, you watch what happens. And who's there with her camera and her pen as boys turn into men? The storm, the gates, and then just watch what happens when they do. Modern-day David is poised to take on the rich and powerful Goliath with the swagger of one twice his age, armed with nothing more than a few nuggets of truth. Jack Kelly stands ready to face the behemoth Pulitzer. Now that's how you turn a boy into a legend. Picture a handsome, heroically charismatic, plain smoking, no-nothing skirt, chasing cocky little son of a lie down with dogs, and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. emotion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of the strike. What a face, face of fact. That's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt an absolute. Power, wait, corrupts. Absolutely, that is genius. But give me some time, I'll be twice as good as that. 6 months from never. Just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. Their mistake is they got old. That is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sure, we'll stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on and I can't watch what happens. All I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
Is anyone else coming?
I got no clue.
Hey, well, you've seen Spot Common, right? What'd he say?
Well, sure, we've seen him.
Him and about 20 of his gang.
And them Brooklyn boys is big.
And I gotta say, Spot was very impressed, wasn't he?
I'd say.
So they're with us!
That all depends on how you look at it. If you look and see Brooklyn, then they're with us.
They wanted proof that we wouldn't fold at the first sign of trouble.
Are we?
We are not! All right, there's us in Harlem.
And not so fast, boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's gonna do.
Well, what about Queens?
Queens will be right there backing us up.
Well, you see?
As soon as we get the nod from Brooklyn.
I got the same fisheye in Midtown.
Say, Oscar, looks like we got bum information about a strike happening today. Not that I'm complaining. My skull-busting arm could use a day of rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Sure, we are.
Hey, maybe we should put this off a couple of days.
No, we can't. Say something. Tell them that if we back down now, they will never listen to us again.
All right, look, we can't back down now. No matter who does or doesn't show, like it or not, now is the time we take a stand. How's about we just don't show up for work? That'll send a message.
No, they'll just replace us, all right? They need to see us stand our ground.
Davey, you tell them.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find a way, but let us seize the day.
Hey, Jack! Look what I made good, huh? Strike!
Oh, that's great! That's pitiful.
Hey, don't be so quick to judge. Maybe Pulitzer will see it out his window and feel sorry for us.
Hey, Specs, any sign of reinforcements? Davey, come on.
Courage cannot erase our fears. Courage is when we face our fears. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey.
Behold the brave battalion that stands side by side, too few in number and
too proud to hide. They say to the others who did not follow through, you're still our brothers, and we will fight for you.
Now is the time to seize the day. Tear down the odds and seize the day. Once we've begun, if we stand as one, someday become somehow, and a prayer becomes a vow,
and the strike starts right there now.
The sun is up and the birds is singing a beautiful day to crack some heads, ain't it? Step right up and get your papes.
You're working or trespassing? What's your pleasure?
Who are they?
What scabs?
What do you think?
If they think they can just waltz in here and take our jobs,
oh, we can handle that.
No, we all stand together or we do not stand a chance. Jack!
I know, all right, I hear you. Fellas, I know someone put you up to this. They probably paid you some extra money, too.
Huh?
Yeah, well, it ain't right. The Pulitzer thinks that we are gutter rats. With no respect for nothing, including each other. Is that who we are? Well, we stab each other in the back, and yeah, that's who we are. But if we stand together, we could change the whole game. And it ain't just about us. You know, all across the city, there are boys and girls who ought to be out there playing or going to school, and instead, they are slaving to support themselves and their folks. There ain't no crime to being poor. But not a one of us complains that the work we do is hard. All we ask is a square deal. Fellas, for the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in this town, I beg you, throw down your papers and join the strike.
Please?
Hey!
I'm with ya.
Now it's time to seize the day.
Now it's time to seize the day.
Answer the call and don't delay.
Answer the call and don't delay. Walls will be riding if we're united.
Them or them?
Now that I hear it loud and clear.
Now that I hear it loud and clear.
Like it or not, we join in.
Like it or not, we're drawing in. Proud and defiant, we'll slay the giant. Judgment Day is here.
What the hell? My thought is gonna kill me anyways.
Yeah, house into heart.
Strike! Strike! Strike!
See how you like this, Mr. Pulitzer. Oh!
We finally got a headline. Newsies crushed as bulls attack. Coachy's calling me. Them crips just too damn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling. Thanks to good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go! Let me go far away, somewhere they won't ever find me, and tomorrow won't remind me of today. When the city's finally sleeping and the moon looks old and gray, I'll get on a train that's bound for Santa Fe. And I'm gone, and I'm done. No more running, no more lying, no more fat old men denying me my pay. Just a moon so big and yellow, it turns night right into day. Dreams come true, yet I do in Santa Fe. Where does it say you gotta live and die here? Where does it say a guy can't catch a break? Why should you only take what you're given? Why should you spend your whole life living trapped? But there ain't no future, even at 17, breaking your back for someone else's sake. If the life don't seem to suit ya, I'll put a change of scene. Far from the lousy headlines and the deadlines in between. Santa Fe, my old friend, I can't spend my whole life dreaming, though I know that's all I seem inclined to do. I ain't getting any younger, and I wanna start brand new. I need space and fresh air. Let them laugh in my face. I don't care, save my place. I'll beat it. Just be real, is all I'm asking. Not some painting in my head, 'cause I'm dead if I can't count on you today. I got nothing if I ain't got Santa Fe.
Boys, and don't ever say I don't give you nothing. And before you say water is nothing, just ask a fish in the desert.
Hey!
Why do old people talk?
To prove they still alive.
Good morning, gentlemen. Would you get a load of these clum mugs? Can these really be the same boys who made front page in the New York Sun?
Give it to me. Oh,
okay. Would you look at that? That's me.
Front page, and you ain't even dead.
Be with me.
Wait till my old man gets a load of this. I won't be last in line for the job tonight.
You got us in the paper?
You got yourselves in the paper.
Newsy, stop the wire!
Yeah!
Now there's a headline even Elma could sell. What else you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer declared a blackout on strike news, so even I'm shut down now. I heard they arrested Crutchy. Did they get Jack too?
The Delanteys are spreading the story that Jack went on the lam. First sight of the cops.
Jack, don't rub no fight!
Hey, take it down, shortstop, and just report in the news.
For jumping Jack's sake, can we just stow the seriosity long enough to just drink in the moment? I'm famous!
Yeah? What of it?
Are you stupid or what? Oh, when you're famous, the world is your oyster.
Huh? Your what?
Your oyster. Yeah. Your fancy clam with a pearl inside.
Oh. But what is being famous?
Hey. Oh, you don't need money when you're famous. It gives you whatever you want. Gratis.
Such as?
A pair of new shoes with matching laces.
A permanent box at the shoes at races.
Pastrami on rye with a sour pickle.
A personal puss on a wooden nickel.
Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Suddenly, I'm respectable, staring right at you, lousy with stature. Nobbing with calls the muckety mucks. I'm blowing my dough and going deluxe. And there I be, and I'm pretty. It's my city, I'm the king of New York.
A gold watch with chains twirling.
My very own bed and an indoor toilet.
Bob Shop's haircut that costs a quarter.
A regular beat for the star reporter.
And straight punk, she's the king of New York.
I'm the king of New York.
We were stuck, pale and pitiful.
Nonchalant noodles, Pulitzer's poodles.
Almost about to drown in the drink when she fished us out.
And drowned us in ink.
So let's get drunk.
Yeah!
With liquor, fame works quicker when you're king of New York.
I gotta be either dead or dreaming. Just look at that paint with my face beaming. Tomorrow they may write fishes in it, but I was a star for one whole minute.
Woo! All right.
Thank you.
Jack. Greetings from the refuge. How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch. Ugh. Oh, yeah, Jack. This is Crutchy, by the way. These here guards, they is rude. They say jump or you're screwed. But the food here ain't badly so far. Cause so far they ain't brung us no food. Ha ha. I miss the rooftop. Sleeping right out in the open. In your penthouse in the sky. There's a cool breeze blowing even in July. Anyway, so guess what? There's this secret escape plan I got. Tie a sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window. Climb down, then take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my legs still ain't right. Hey, Pulitzer, he's going down. And then Jack, I was thinking we might just go like you were saying. Where it's clean and green and pretty, with no buildings in your way, where you're riding palominos every day. Once that train makes, oh, damn this place. No, I'll be fine, good as new. But there's one thing I need you to do. On the rooftop you said that a family looks out for each other. So you tell all the fellas for me to protect one another. The end. Your friend. No, your best friend. Brother Crutchy.
You in there, pipe down!
Everything I owe you for the first backdrop plus this one and a little extra just on account of because I'm gonna miss you so.
Miss Meta, I...
Jack.
You're a gem.
Just please tell me you're going somewhere and not running away.
Does it matter?
When you go somewhere and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else. But if you're running away, nowhere is ever the right place.
Oh, how about letting a pal know you're alive?
I'll leave you with your friend.
Where'd you go? We couldn't find you.
You ever think I didn't want to be found?
Is that a real place? Is that Santa Fe? Did you see the paper? We are front page news above the fold. Oh, yes, above the fold.
Yeah, good for you.
Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. They even spot Conlin sent a kid over just to say next event you can count on Brooklyn. How about that?
We got stomped into the ground.
They got us this time. I'll grant you that. But with press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newsie who could walk showed up this morning to sell papes, like the strike never happened.
And I was there with them. If I don't sell papes, my folks don't eat.
Look, just save your breath. All right, I get it. It's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. And I realized this isn't over. We've got them worried, really worried. And I walked away, and lots of other kids did too, and that is what you call a beginning.
There it is, just like I said.
For crying out loud, where's a fella gotta go to get away from you people?
There's no escaping us, pal. We're inevitable.
So, what's the story? Can we have the theater?
A pipe down. I didn't ask yet.
Well, what's the holdup? I need to let my girl know we got a date.
Your girl.
You heard me. I've been swatting skirts away all morning. Famous one intoxicating potion. And this here girl, Sally, she's a plum.
You know, word is you wrote a great story.
You look like hell. Hey, Jack, what's that supposed to be?
Oh, that's Santa Fe.
I gotta tell you, Jack, this Go West young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York. Yes, he did. And then he died.
Ain't reporters supposed to be nonpartisan?
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town. Can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meta let us have the theater?
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally, a citywide meeting where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we do it after working hours, so no one loses a day's pay. Smart.
Yeah, smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy?
Oh, you want to see a place I've seen? Huh? Well, how about this? Newsies Square. And thanks to my big mouth filled to overflowing with failure. Kids hurt. Others arrested.
Well, lighten up. No one died.
Oh, is that what you're aiming for? No. Go on. Call me a quitter. Call me a coward. There is no way I am putting them kids back in danger.
You're doing something that has never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a note from Crutchy. At the refuge. I tried to go see him. I climbed up the fire escape. They busted him up so bad, he couldn't even come to the window. Now, what if he don't make it? Are you willing to shoulder that for a tenth of a penny of pay?
It's not about pennies. You said it yourself. If my father had a union, my family wouldn't be in the mess we're in now. This is a fight we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up for church.
Tell me how quitting does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So, here's how it goes. Once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
Right.
And we'll tell them straight out they let Crutchy go or they keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked. They won.
Won the battle.
Oh, come on.
Jackie, think about it. We've got them surrounded.
Here's what I think. Joe's a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. And you know why a snake starts to rattle?
No, why?
Because he's scared.
Sure.
Go and look it up. The poor guy's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops. And
you know, you may be right.
Oh, thank you, God.
If he wasn't afraid.
Exactly.
He knows we're winning. Get those kids to see we're circling victory and watch what happens. We're doing something no one's even tried. And yes, we're terrified, but watch what happens. Your kids undo the past.
So just move on and
stay on track. Cause Humpty Dumpty is about to crack.
We've got faith.
We've got the plan.
And we've got Jack.
So just watch what happens.
Thank you.
read your editorials, Mr. Pulitzer, and I don't understand how you could express so much sympathy for the trolley workers, and yet have none for the Newsies.
Because the trolley workers are striking for a fair contract. The Newsies are striking against me.
Well, I'd spare you this embarrassment if I could, but the burlesque house is private property.
She can't order a raid without legal cause.
Ah, but Madam Mayor, would the fact that this rally is organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive at large from one of our own institutions, wreaking mischief on our law-abiding community. Mr. Schneider, which one did you say he was?
That one there, Jack Kelly.
And how do you know this boy?
His is not a pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, but his total disregard for authority has made him a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief and an escaped convict.
After his release, I caught him myself, red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was last sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So you'd be doing the city a service, removing this criminal from our streets.
Well, if that's the case, we can take him in quietly.
What good would quiet do me? I want a public example made of the boy.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here?
He's just outside. He's asked to see you.
Ask and ye shall be received. Mr. Schneider, if you please. Go.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Afternoon there.
And which Jack Kelly is this? Charismatic union organizer or a petty thief? An escaped convict?
Well, which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Oh, crawling, huh? That's a laugh. No, I just dropped by with an invite. It seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements, and I thought it only fair to invite you to state your case straight to the fellas. So what do you say, Joe? When I should save you a spot in the bill?
You are as shameless and disrespectful a creature as I was told. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
Yeah, and how'd that turn out for you?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
Well, I'll keep that in mind when New York wakes up tomorrow morning to front page photos of our rally.
Rally till the cows come home. Not a paper in town will publish a word. And if it's not in the paper, it's never happened.
You know, you may run this city, but there are some of us who can't be bullied. Even some reporters.
Oh, like that young woman who made you yesterday's news? Talented girl and beautiful as well, don't you think?
Yeah, I'll tell her you said so.
No need. She can hear for herself, can't you, darling? I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. That's right, my daughter. Now you might be wondering, why the nom de plume? Why doesn't my daughter work for me? And good questions. You see, I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure, but she chose to pursue a career, and she was showing great promise with that, too, until this recent lapse. But you're all done with that now, aren't you, darling?
Jack.
Don't bother the boy with your problems, sweetheart. Mr. Kelly's got a plate full of his own, wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
No, stop.
Ow! Does anyone else feel a noose tightening? But allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You attend the rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I will see your criminal record expunged and your pockets filled with enough cash to carry you in a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stink!
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, And I will see to it that you and every one of your little friends are locked up in the refuge.
I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but it isn't right to condemn that little crippled boy to such conditions.
And what about your pal Davy and his baby brother ripped from their loving family and thrown to the rats? Will they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, kid, so what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line.
Gentlemen, escort our guest to the cellar, where he might reflect in solitude.
Too bad you've no job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you've no family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line.
Like the Pied Piper, you knew what to play.
Till those kids all believed you were right.
Lucky for them, but one got away.
They may not be so lucky tonight.
We've been given discretion to handle you as we see fit. So behave.
Just in case, I've been polishing my favorite brass knuckles.
You can sleep right there on that old printing press.
Now that then is firm.
Newsies need our help today.
Newsies need our help today.
Tell them Brooklyn's on their way.
Tell them Brooklyn's on their way.
We're from
Brooklyn.
We are
Newsies.
We are Brooklyn Newsies. Just a word that our bodies inspire in facing total disaster. That's our cue, boys. It's time to go. With the boys from the beaches of pride in Prospect Park and the Navy Yard Pier. Strikes ain't fun, but the shore is exciting. Loud and clear, Brooklyn's here.
For what Kate needs first, friendliest place on earth. Pay us a visit and see what we mean. And when you do,
we'll kick you halfway in the wind. Now them soakers is in for a soaking. What a sad way to end a career. It's a joke, but it makes for joking. Loud and clear.
But that is here.
She's here.
What's I see?
To my theater and your revolution!
Hey, let's hear it for Spot Conlon and for Brooklyn.
Yeah. Nosies united.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see what Pulitzer has to say to us now.
Hey, Davey, where's Jack? Oh,
No sign of him, kid. Jack. Looks like you're doing a solo.
Newsies of New York! Look at what we've done. We've got newsies from every pape and every neighborhood here tonight. Tonight, you're making history. Tonight, we declare we're just as much a part of the newspaper as any reporter or editor. We're done being treated like kids. From now on, they will treat us as equals.
You want to be talked to like an adult and start acting like one. Don't just run your mouth, make some sense.
And here is Jack.
Jack, 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 Jack.
All right. Pull
Pulitzer raised the price of papes without so much as a word to us. And that was a lousy thing to do. So we got mad and let them know we ain't gonna be pushed around. So we go on strike. Then what happens? Pulitzer lowers his price so we'll get back to work. And then a few weeks later, he hikes his price back up again, and don't think he won't. So what do we do then? And what do we do if he decides to raise his price again after that? I mean, fellas, we gotta be realistic. All right, we don't work, we don't get paid. How many days can you go without making money? However long, believe me, Pulitzer can go longer. But I have spoken to Mr. Pulitzer, and he has given me his word. If we disband the union, he will not respect against for 2 years, all right? He'll even put it in writing. I say we take the deal, get back to work knowing our price is secure. All we need to do is vote no.
No, I'm not going to
vote no.
What's
no.
What the hell? Why are you at work, Jack? I hate this one.
Try to find.
Jack!
Come on, baby.
That was some speech you made.
How'd you get here?
Specs showed me.
He said you could go through my stuff?
I saw them rolled up sticking out of there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings. These are drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is this really what it's like in there? 3 boys to a bed, rats everywhere, and vermin?
Yeah, a little different from where you were raised.
Snyder told my father you were arrested stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you were willing to go to jail for those boys, how could you turn your back on them now?
I do not think you are anyone to talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
Oh, no, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I never lied. I didn't tell you everything.
If you weren't a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I told you I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real one.
I wouldn't think I had to unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
And if I were a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swollen eye.
Oh, yeah, well, don't let that stop you, huh? Give me your best shot.
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
No, I spoke the truth. You in a fight when you got the other fella down eating pavement. You heard your father. No matter how many days we go on strike, he ain't giving up. I don't know what else we can do.
But I do.
Oh, come on.
Really, Jack? Really? Only you can have a good idea. Or is it because I'm a girl?
Well, I didn't say nothing.
This would be a good time to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers. Just the brains to recognize the right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you. The strike was your idea. The rally was Davies, and now my plan will bring us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The Children's Crusade?
For the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in New York, I beg you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped being just about the Newsies. You challenged our whole generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
The Children's Crusade.
Think, Jack. If we publish this, my words, with one of your drawings, and if every worker under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, came to Newsy Square, a general citywide strike, even my father couldn't ignore that.
There's only one
small problem. We got no way to print it.
Come on, there has to be one printing press he doesn't control.
Oh, no.
What?
I know what is a printing press that no one would ever think we'd use.
Then why are we still standing here?
Hey, wait, stop. What's this about for you? I don't mean the children's crusade. What's this about? I mean, am I kidding myself, or is there something?
Of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens every day.
Jack,
No, I am not an idiot. I know girls like you don't wind up with guys like me, and I don't want you promising nothing you gotta take back later. But standing here tonight, looking at you, I'm scared tomorrow's gonna come in and change everything. If there was a way I could just grab hold of something to make time stop, just so as I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. I never even saw it coming.
For sure?
For sure. Till the moment I found you, I thought I knew what love was. Now I'm learning what is true, that love will do what it does. The world finds ways to sting you, and then one day decides to bring you something to believe in for even a night. One night, maybe forever, but that's all right. That's all right. And if you're gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in, now that I know you believed in me.
We was never meant to meet, and then we meet. Who knows why? One more stranger on the street, just someone sweet passing by. An angel come to save me, didn't even know she gave me something to believe in for even a day. One day, maybe forever. That's okay. That's okay. And if I'm gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in, now that I know you believed in me. Different.
If you weren't going to Santa Fe,
and if you weren't an heiress, and if your father wasn't after my head,
you're not really scared of my father.
No, but I am pretty scared of you.
Don't be.
And if I'm gone tomorrow,
what was ours still will be.
I have something to believe.
I'll get the lights. You get those windows unlocked.
You got enough keys here for the entire building. Has someone been picking Daddy's pockets?
The janitor's been working here since he was 8 and hasn't had a raise in 20 years. He's with us 100%.
Hey, you bring enough fellas to keep us covered?
Oh, we could hold a hoe down in here. No one would be the wiser.
Good job.
Hey, it's good to have you back. Again.
Shut up.
Here she is, boys. Just think. While my father snores blissfully in his bed, we will be using his very own printing press to bring him down.
Remind me to stay on your good side.
Is this what they print the papes on?
I can see why they toss this old girl down to the cellar, but I think she will do the job.
Jack, this is Darcy. He knows just about everything there is to know about printing.
Wow. You work for one of the papes?
My father owns the Trib.
Whoa.
And this is Betty. She'll be typesetting the article for us.
Oh, Betty. I suppose you're the daughter of William Randolph Hearst.
And proud to be a part of your revolution.
Ain't that something?
In the words of the little one, can we table the palaver and get down to business?
A little bit of grease, and she'll be as good as gold.
All right, here's how it'll work. As we print the papes, race, you and I will let the fellas in, and they'll spread them to every working kid in New York. After that?
After that, it's up to them.
There's change coming once and for all. You makes the front page, and man, you is major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are, and sure as a star, we ain't come this far. This is the story we needed to write as we kept out of sight, but no more. In a few hours, by dawn's early light, we'll be ready to fight us a war. This time we're in it to stay. Talk about seizing the day.
Write it in ink or in blood, it's the same either way. They're gonna damn well pay.
See old man Poland sits snug in his bed. He don't care if we're dead or alive. Three satin pillows are under his head while he's begging for bread to survive. Joe, you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing in his sleep. Then while he snooze, we'll be lighting a fuse with a promise we're taking the key.
Once and for all, if they don't mind their manners, we'll bleed them.
Bleed them.
Once and for all, we will carry no banners that don't.
This time whatever it takes. This time the Union awakes. Once and for all.
In the words of Union leader Jack Kelly, we will work with you. We will even work for you, but we will be paid and treated as valuable members of your organizations. Riveting stuff, huh?
Hey, get going. You got a very important man to see.
Keep your fingers crossed.
For us too.
This is for kids shining shoes on the street with no shoes on their feet every day. This is for guys sweating blood in the shops while their bosses and cops look away. I'm seeing kids standing tall, glaring and raring a brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the lines, getting ready to rise in the cold. Once and for all. Once and for all.
Joy!
can't come to the phone right now. He's really busy.
Back, please? Hold.
But I don't know where he's in Santa Fe. He's in Santa Fe.
Please hold.
I'm sorry. He's not here right now.
The entire city is shut down. Nobody is working anywhere, and everyone is blaming you.
They're all calling the mayor, the publishers, the manufacturers. And such language. Oh.
You can't just barge in.
How we doing this morning, gents?
You're behind this. We had a deal.
Oh, and it came with a money-back guarantee. And thanks for your lessons on the powers of the press.
Did you read this, boss? Kids put out a pretty good paper. Very convincing.
No doubt written by my daughter.
Oh, I'd sign it before someone else grabs her up.
I demand to know who violated my ban on printing strike materials.
Oh, but we are your loyal employees. We'd never take our business elsewhere.
The old printing press in the cellar.
I made you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who doesn't act in his own self-interest is a fool.
What's that make you? This all started because you wanted to sell more papers. Now your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Yeah, guys like Joe don't talk to nothings like us. But a very wise reporter once told me that a real boss don't need all the answers. Just the smarts to snatch the right one when he hears it.
Have a look out there, Mr. Pulitzer. In case you haven't figured it out, we've got you surrounded.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't get a paper or shoe shine. You can't send a message or ride an elevator or cross the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even leave your own building. So what's your next move?
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor is here, along with your daughter and, you're not going to believe who else.
Good morning, Mr. Pulitzer. I believe you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt!
Joseph! 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 What have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation—
Thanks to Miss Metalarkin, bringing your daughter to my office, I have a thorough grasp of the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Thank you. Bully is the expression I employ to show approval. And in this case, I simply mean bully. And this is the boy of whom you spoke. How are you, son? I'm told we shared a carriage ride.
The pleasure is mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just stand there letting those children sing endlessly. Tell them the good news.
What good news?
That you finally come to your senses and rolled back the prices.
Yes.
Unless, of course, you want a full state Senate investigation into your employment practices.
Now you would.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office, I do with a smile. Come along, Joe. There's one thing worse than a hard heart, and that's a soft head. And think of the happiness you'll bring those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak with you alone.
Keep your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I can't put the price of the paperback where it was. I'm sorry, I just can't. There are other
Look,
Joe,
I get it. You need to save face in front of the other fellas. I'm young. I ain't stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
Well, what if I cut the raise by half and made the others do the same? It's a compromise we can all live with.
But you eat our losses. From now on, whatever papes we can't sell, you buy back full price.
That was never on the table. What's to stop Newsies from buying hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs would explode.
No Newsie is gonna break his back hauling around papes he can't sell. But if they can take a few more with no risk, they might sell them and your circulation will begin to grow.
It's a compromise we can all live with.
That's not a bad head you've got on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
It's just the price of doing business.
And the world will know we've been keeping score. Either they gives us our rights or we gives them a war.
We've been out too long
and we paid our dues. And the things we do today will be tomorrow's news. And the die is cast.
Of New York City, we won!
And now I'd like to introduce my own personal pal, Governor Theodore Roosevelt himself.
Each generation must, at the height of its power, step aside and invite the young to share the day. You have laid claim to our world, and I believe the future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. Your drawings, son, have brought another matter to bear. Officer, if you please.
Hey, look at Dad! It's Crunchy!
Hiya, fellas. Did you miss me?
Yeah.
And look at what I got you. A gift straight from the refuge. Bring him in, fellas!
He's Snyder the Spider!
Look, he's so tough no more, is he?
Jack, your drawings have made an eloquent argument for shutting down the refuge. Be assured that Mr. Snyder's abuses will be fully investigated. Officer, take him away.
Oh, please, Your Highness, may I do the honors?
You've got to be joking!
Oh, and you'll be laughing all the way to the pen, little man. So long, sucker!
Oh!
Thank you, Mr. Governor.
Come on. Oh. I can't help but think, if just one of your drawings convinced the governor to shut down the refuge, what might a daily political cartoon do to expose the dealings in our own government backrooms? What do you say, Teddy? Care to have this young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed door?
Hey, hey, don't sweat it, Gov. With the strike settled, I should probably be hitting the road.
Don't you ever get tired of singing the same old tune. What Santa Fe got that New York ain't? Tarantulas?
Or better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
Hey, New York's got us, and we're a family.
Didn't I hear something about a strike being settled?
Papes for the Newsies! Line up, boys! These papes ain't gonna sell themselves!
Come along, Governor, and show me that back seat I've heard so much about.
Well, don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. Besides, didn't someone just offer you a pretty exciting job?
Me? Work for your father?
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
Besides, you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
What would that be?
Me? Wherever you go, I'm there, right by your side.
For sure?
For sure.
It don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes
And some made-up world is all you've ever seen. Now my eye stays finally open, and my dream stays average size. But they don't much matter if you ain't with me.
So, Jack, are you in or you out?
I'm in.